Hello, I'm Joe Hart, and welcome to Reno. You know, whenever I visit a place, I like to talk to the locals and find out what it is they like to do and what makes their town so special. Well, we have a pretty special city here, and we'd like to share it with you. Downtown Reno, right along our famous Truckee River, where a lot of work has gone into opening this up into a water park of sorts. And whether you're a kayaker, a tuber, or just a sunbather, Reno's water park has become a central attraction in the summer months.
I remember Elizabeth and Joe said, "Hey, Dad, this is like really neat. Can we go float down the Truckee like all those people are?" I said, "Well, why not? Let's go." So we got three big inner tubes, tied them together, and we took the whole family and a couple of friends and floated down the Truckee.
I don't think a lot of people really understand how beautiful the river traveling through our downtown is and the beautiful walks, and especially in the fall when the leaves are turning and the leaves are falling, and it's beautiful. You can stop for a cup of coffee or at a little shop or stop into the Museum of Art. It's just a really culturally, creatively wonderful area that I don't think a lot of people really know about.
And for those of us who live here, it is just one of our many treasures. Downtown, of course, has its entertainment district, but starting along the river, it has become one of our thriving arts and culture districts where we have art houses, theaters, museums, and so much more.
We have terrific cultural opportunities here in this community that most communities this size simply don't have.
And David should know, as the new executive director for the museum, his surprise and delight with the art and culture that Reno has to offer was a little eye-opening.
I think people are always surprised that a city of this size has a cultural asset like the Nevada Museum of Art. It's a stunning building. And I think it really sets a tone for what the rest of the trip will be like.
Of course, if performance art is more to your liking, then Reno has that in spades. From our Philharmonic Orchestra to the Shakespeare Festival, our arts community sings, dances, and shouts from the rooftops.
The fact that we have as many people coming in as tourists and visitors to our community has provided us with a number of offerings that a community our size might not normally have.
We have a fantastic Philharmonic, the Reno Philharmonic. It would rate in most cities in America. We have terrific cultural opportunities here in this community that most communities this size simply don't have.
For those who get more energized by tackles than tutus and would rather see grown men fight rather than sing, well, Reno's a pretty competitive sports town too. For college sports, Nevada's bowl-winning football team is always a sure bet on a Saturday in the fall.
The football games are phenomenal, and how cool is it that UNR went to the Craft Bowl and finally beat Boise.
What I like best, though, is the smell of the grass and the crack of the bat in downtown Reno. Yes, that's right, AAA pro baseball right here in downtown. Well, not right here, but just a short stroll away. In fact, just downriver a few blocks. Come on, we'll head over. You know, there's nothing better than a day at the ballpark, and for AAA baseball, there is no better place to be than the Reno Aces ballpark. It has all the excitement of the majors, sized down just a little for those of us here in Reno.
When they come into town, there's a lot of different places. The first place I'm gonna take them is at the ballpark. It's a beautiful facility. We have the Freight House District there,
which is really cool. It has like 5 restaurants and a nice bar overlooking the Aces Stadium.
And there's nothing like this in the PCL and all of baseball, that you have a entertainment district and a baseball park. And they absolutely are wowed.
Sitting right next to the casino district, it has become a popular attraction for Reno's locals and visitors alike. Not that attractions in the summer months are hard to come by any means, especially the ones that come in almost every weekend starting in May and running until October. I'm talking about Reno's many special events.
I'm an automobile buff, so you know I like Hot August Nights. I love just walking through there, all the different, you know, models and makes that they have.
We have the Shakespeare Festival at Lake Tahoe.
Well, I've been to the balloon races, and that's a sight to see. It's absolutely gorgeous.
The Reno Tahoe Open. You have the Reno Rodeo. You got street vibrations. You got the balloon races. You got the air races. You have the Italian Festival. You have all these different amenities that come downtown. And it's a beautiful thing, and I think we take that for granted because there's so many exciting things to do right here in Reno.
More than the events, our biggest year-round attraction is the beautiful Sierra Nevada Mountains.
I think one of the things that is always surprising if they've never been to Reno is the fact that the mountains are just right there. I think people have this other picture of Reno and they don't really think about the fact that our beautiful mountains are just so close.
Well, Lake Tahoe, of course, is world class. It's a world class destination. It's stunning. It's beautiful.
That's such a gem of a lovely place, and people from all over the world go there.
When you come over the summit and you see the lake for the first time with the mountains in the background, it's absolutely breathtaking.
And I've always heard that it's one of the top 10 places in the world as far as just beauty. Well, I'm not sure I believe that, but when I went back up this last time, and it was very recent, I looked at it again. I said, that's not top 10, it's gotta be top 5. And I'm not sure it's not the number one in the world.
For outdoor enthusiasts, sports fanatics, and nature lovers, there is something for everyone up in the mountains.
I was taken back by all the amenities that surround Reno, all the great things. I mean, listen, I'm a fisherman. How many lakes can I choose to go fly fishing on? In fact, we even caught fish in the back of the ballpark, in the Truckee.
In the summer, we go to Donner Lake, which is only about 40 minutes away, and swim. We ride our bikes around Truckee and Tahoe and even our neighborhood. We always laugh because we're about 15 minutes away from some of the greatest terrain in all of the country.
I think a lot of people don't realize that there are days when you can go skiing in the mountains in the morning and show up on a golf course in the afternoon all in one day.
And you can even get a taste of nature right here in the Reno area. The trails along the river, the many ranch and wilderness areas in the neighborhoods of our city, and the variety of parks that we have all help bring nature to our front doors.
It's a stunning place to live, to know that outside, literally outside some of our back doors, is wilderness areas, designated wilderness areas that I can walk to from where I live.
Sometimes we just take the dogs out. We live over in Damani Ranch, and we run the trails, and there's actually wild horses, which most people probably don't have in their backyard.
And with all this activity, it's a good thing Reno has top-notch medical care. I think you'd be hard-pressed to find another city our size with the kind of services that we provide. And having a medical school and a focus on science and technology research at our university has only added to our expertise.
The University of Nevada is a beautiful, beautiful campus, sitting in a lovely location with incredible offerings from an educational standpoint. I don't think most people realize the caliber of teaching and research and opportunities that go on at our university.
The medical community has just expanded to the point where it's a remarkably sophisticated community. I mean, many years ago, people in Reno, prominent people, would go to California for their medical care. That just does not happen 34 years later.
I don't think I've been in any university, and I've been in quite a few across the country that have the technology that we have, the Knowledge Center, and it's a beautiful building.
The Knowledge Center is something that people should just go visit. Every person in Reno should just go check out the Knowledge Center. It's amazing.
It's just a rare combination of being on the border of this great outdoors and mountain ranges where we live, and great educational community, a medical school, a university. To achieve that combination is very rare in the United States.
So what do I love best about Reno? Well, that's a tough question. I enjoy the river and the many events, and I love the mountains surrounding the city, and of course Lake Tahoe, not to mention the proximity to San Francisco and the wine country. But what is best about Reno? Well, I'd have to say the people.
People here are the most genuine, authentic people I've ever seen. They're kind of rough and tough like the old Southwest, but you know what? They're fiercely independent, but very friendly. And I love that aspect about this town.
I think Reno's really made of wonderful people and easy access to people of power. Oh, I always laugh because I see the mayor. He knows my name, can shake his hand. I see him at different lunch functions, and I don't think other communities have that opportunity.
And we've really enjoyed getting to know people very quickly. And people have become close friends very quickly. And that's what happens in a community.
Yes, it is the people. They're what make the biggest little city great. And every time I meet someone new in town, it's not long before they tell me the same thing, that it's a great place to live and enjoy life. Well, we hope you come back for a visit. And if you stay for just a little while, I might be saying hi to a new neighbor. Well, it looks like it's time for me to go find my seat at the game.